KD Neon is very minimal and clean distribution. It has only the Ubuntu base and Plasma 5 desktop. It doesn't have many pre-installed applications or pre-configured things. That's why in this video I would like to show you the essential 15 things to do after installing KD Neon in 2020. And the first thing I recommend is to disable DoubleClick. By default, after you have installed KD Neon, if you open any application and you want to select a folder, for example like here, if I click on it, it will open it with a single click, because by default, single click acts as a double click. But I believe double click is a bit more common behavior, and I also prefer using double click. That's why I disable single click. And to do that, you need to go to settings, then you need to go to behavior, and here you just need to change behavior from single click to double click. Apply. Now, whenever you click on any folder here, it will be selected, as you can see. But if you double click, you will enter that folder. I know it is a bit controversial and some people like single click acting as double click, but I prefer a bit more traditional behavior, and I think many new users will like it too. The second thing after installing KD Neon, I recommend you to learn how to update your KD Neon correctly. For that, you need to open terminal, which is called console in KD Neon. Let's make it a bit bigger. And here you need to type a little bit different command than you used to type if you used Ubuntu, for example. You need to type sudo pkcon, then you type refresh, then you type these two addition signs, and the next command which will run right after this command will be again sudo pkcon update. So this is the recommended way to update KD Neon. If you don't believe me, go to KD Neon website and you will find this recommendation. After you enter your password, it will check for available updates and offer you to install some of the updates. You say yes and install them. So if you run KD Neon, please use this command. I also leave it in the description. Install Synaptic Package Manager. KD Neon has built-in package manager, which is called Discover, and you can use it. It is a nice user-friendly package manager, but unfortunately it is very slow and it does not contain all the packages you can install in KD Neon. That's why I recommend you to install Synaptic Package Manager. Using Synaptic, you can install any available package or library in KD Neon. And to show you how to install it, I will use terminal again, just to show you that you still can use apt install in KD Neon. For example, if you type sudo apt install synaptic, press enter, type your password, and this way you can install Synaptic Package Manager in KD Neon similar to how you would install it in Ubuntu. And after the installation, I will show you how you can use Synaptic Package Manager in KD Neon. This will be in step number 4, which is install drivers. And to install drivers in KD Neon, you need to open Synaptic. You will need to enter password to open it. After you have opened it, go to search and search for Kubuntu driver. And this will find you Kubuntu driver manager. Then you mark it for installation, mark all the dependencies, click apply and install Kubuntu driver manager. You can also enable this feature to automatically close this window after the installation process. When it is installed, pull Synaptic Package Manager and search for driver manager in menu. It will take some time to update the information about your system, as you can see here, and after that you should see some drivers offered for installation. I am recording this video in the VirtualBox, so that's why it offers me to install some VirtualBox drivers, but I don't need to install them. In your case, if you use Nvidia graphic card or if you need some proprietary Wi-Fi driver, most likely these drivers will be offered here, so you can select them and install. Install essential applications. By default, KDNU is very clean distribution and it does not have many applications pre-installed. It is so minimal that you will find only a few applications in multimedia, no office suite, but you can easily install all of them with this simple command. You open terminal and then you just need to type this command, which I will leave in the description, and it will install, for example, Ubuntu Restricted Extra, which includes such packages like Codex, for example, to decode MP3 files and other multimedia files, Build Essential, which most likely you will need if you install some additional programs on your system, LibreOffice, which is Office Suite. It also includes some additional packages for LibreOffice to integrate it with Plasma 5 Desktop. There is VLC Player, which is installed in KDE Neon, but I have recently started to use SM Player in my KDE Neon, and I like it little more because it is lighter, it starts faster, and it closes also faster. VLC is a bit heavy and it is a little slow sometimes. To play audio files, I use Clementine. Cap is a backup program, which I have shown in one of my previous videos, which you can watch by clicking on this card here. Then I also install Image Viewer, which is GlenView, Kate for text editor. I prefer to use Kate instead of Kwrite, which is installed in KDE Neon. GIMP is image editor, you may install it, you may skip, it's up to you. SpeedCrunch is a bit advanced calculator. Chromium browser is another browser. There is Firefox, which is installed, but I recommend you to have two browsers on your system because sometimes different web pages may look a little different in different browsers. KTorrent is a torrent client, KFind is a search application which will help you to perform advanced search on your KDE Neon. Partition Manager is a bit advanced application, but I recommend you to install it in case you need to do something with your partitions, or even, for example, if you need to format your USB drive. This is the application you can use. Then I have installed this package, which is necessary to preview PNG images in Dolphin. NGUFW is a Firefox application, which we will use in one of the next steps of things to do after installing KDE Neon. So let's press enter and install all these programs. So I'm not going to show you all these programs because it will take a lot of time, but after the installation, you will find all of them in your menu and you can start using them. I believe this is the minimum set which is essential for any desktop to make it a usable desktop. Next thing I recommend to do is to enable night color. Night color reduces the amount of blue light on your screen at night, which is better for your eyes and improves your sleep. You can easily enable it in KDE Neon if you open settings. Then you need to go to display and monitor. And here you will find night color and you just need to activate it. The default settings are usually okay, but you can of course adjust if you want. After you have enabled it, you need to apply, and now your screen will reduce the amount of blue light at night. Disable KDE Neon Wallet subsystem. Many new users get scared or confused by this application, which often pop up on your screen and ask you to enter your password. Indeed, sometimes it is annoying. I personally use KDE Wallet, but I know that many users want to disable it. That's why I would like to show you how to disable it. If you go to the settings, then you need to search KDE Wallet here, and you just disable it here. Then you apply, enter your password. Now KDE Wallet subsystem is disabled and you won't see those annoying pop-ups. Disable Restore Previous Session. This is another feature which is enabled by default, and I find it very annoying, like double click, for example. So what it does, for example, now I have terminal open, and if I shut down my system and start it again, it will start with this terminal open again. And if you have many applications open, it will remember all these applications, and when you reboot your system, KDE Neon will open all those applications. I think this makes system a bit slow when you start it, and I usually don't need to launch all the applications I had opened previous time, so I recommend you to disable this feature. And again, you need to go to the system settings, then you type here session, go to desktop session, and here you need to choose start with an empty session, or you can choose restore manually saved session, but I usually prefer to have empty session when I start my system. Apply, Now, whenever you start your system, it will always start with the new fresh session, regardless of what was the state when you shut down your system. This is the default behavior of most systems. Enable automatic spell checking. If you go to settings and search for spell checking here, you will see that automatic spell checking is not enabled by default, but I recommend you to enable it. This way, whenever you type anywhere, KDE Neon will try to spell check your typing, and this will improve your writing. Disable file content index. By default, KDE Neon will index everything what is available on your system, including content of text files and other files. And this usually makes your system slow, and also it takes a lot of space, because these index files are very large. In most of the cases, you search files by their name and not by their content. So I recommend you to disable that feature because, as I said, it will make your system faster and it will also save a lot of space. You need to go to the search menu, and here you keep enable file search, but you disable index file content. Then you click apply. Now your search will still work. You will be able to find most of your files, but you would need to use file names instead of file content. Configure Dolphin. Dolphin is my favorite Linux file manager. I think it's the best. And in KDE Neon, it is already pre-configured, but you can make it much better because it has many, many features. For example, you can increase number of shortcuts here. By default, you have only desktop, documents, and downloads. But you can place here your music folder, for example, your picture folder, and all the others or any other folder you want. Then I go to the menu, go to Dolphin Preferences, and here I enable Remember Display Style for each folder. So this way, I can have different folder view for different folders. For example, I have icon style view on my home folder. But if I go, for example, to Documents, I can have a list view here. But when I return to my home folder, I still have icons view here, because by default, you would have the same view style in every directory when you change it. I think it is more productive to have different style for different folders. Because if you have many files, you want to have a list view. But if you have image folder, you want to have icon view. I think this feature is available only in Dolphin File Manager. And that's why it's my favorite file manager. Change application menu. This is the default menu of KDE Neon. And I think it is fine if you use search bar, but if you want to navigate somewhere, it takes a lot of steps, as you can see. But if you right click here, go to show alternatives, you can choose application menu here instead of application launcher. Click switch, and now your menu will look like this, and you can easily navigate between different categories simply by scrolling through them. You see, I believe this menu is much easier to navigate, and you still have your search. For example, you search for console and it will appear here. I don't know why KDE Neon does not use this menu by default. I think it is much better. Change Firefox settings. Firefox is pre-installed by default in KDE Neon, but you can still improve it a bit if you change some of its default settings. For example, if you go to Preferences, you can enable Restore Previous Session. This way, when you close Firefox with many tabs open, next time you open it, it will open the same tabs. This is very useful. You can also change the style of this top bar. For example, this is a default top bar, but I prefer to have both URL bar and search bar. So that's why I use this style. Also in the general tab, if you scroll down, I recommend you to enable DRM controlled content, because this way you will be able to play videos on such websites as Netflix. And after you have opened Firefox, you will also see this notification in the system tray, which will ask you to install Plasma 5 integration for Firefox. I recommend you to do that. You click Add, and then you need to allow it. So now your Firefox is integrated with Plasma 5 desktop in KDE Neon. Decrease swap use. By default, Linux system uses some amount of your RAM, and after it reaches certain level of your RAM memory, it will start writing those files to the disk, which is called swap partition. But swap partition is very slow in comparison to RAM memory. We can force our system to use as much RAM as possible and start using swap partition only when the maximum RAM is reached. This way your system is usually a little bit faster. You can easily do that in KDE Neon. You need to open console, and you need to type this command to check the current state of your swap value. And the default value is 60. But you can easily change it to 10 to force your system to use as much RAM as possible. To do that, you need to type sudo nano atcctl.conf, enter your password, scroll down to the end of this file, and type here vm.swapness equal 10. Ctrl O to save this file, and Ctrl X to exit. So next time you reboot your system, you will see the swappiness value is equal to 10. And this way, your KDE Neon will use as much RAM as possible and will reduce the amount of writes to your hard drive, which is also sometimes beneficial if you run KDE Neon on SSD drive, for example. Enable Firewall. We have installed Firewall previously when we installed essential applications for KDE Neon, so you should be able to find it in your menu. If you type Firewall, you will find it, enter the password to open it, and then you just need to enable it. If you want to learn more about how to use Firewall in Linux, I have a dedicated video on the Linux Firewall. Please watch it. So now your system has all the essential applications and all the essential configuration to make it a usable desktop. I hope you will like your KDE Neon. Thank you for watching.